We're here at the UC Berkeley Seismology Station where they reported the strong earthquake at exactly 5:04 p.m.
Their equipment went off the scale. This quake was so sharp. Epicenter 10 miles northeast of Santa Cruz.
We can expect some aftershocks. We've already had some aftershocks.
On Tuesday, October 17th, 1989, at 17 hours, 4 minutes, 15 seconds Pacific Daylight Time, a strong motion earthquake emanated from a location 60 miles south-southeast of San Francisco near Loma Prieta in the Santa Cruz mountain range. The main shock, the largest to strike the San Francisco Bay Area since 1906, ruptured a segment of the San Andreas Fault and had a magnitude of 7.1. On October 26, 1989, at the direction of CHP Commissioner Maury Hannigan, a special investigation team comprised of accident reconstruction specialists from the California Highway Patrol was formed. This team was established to identify, collect, and document all of the factual information and available data from the earthquake-induced failure and collapse of two major bi-level elevated interstate freeway structures. Two 50-foot-long roadway segments of Interstate 80 on the San Francisco-Oakland Bay Bridge collapsed, along with a 3/4-mile-long segment of Interstate 880 freeway known as the Cypress Street Viaduct. On October 17th at 5 p.m., as the third game of the 1989 World Series was about to begin, the wind was from the northwest at 13 knots. Barometric pressure was 29.97, dew point was 45 degrees, visibility was 8 miles, and the temperature around the Bay Area was 75 degrees.
First time in 27 years a World Series game will be played in Candlestick Park. The Battle of the Bay continues.
At second base, so the Oakland A's take.
Hey, well, we haven't heard.
There go the lights.
911.
Yeah, this is an emergency in San Francisco. What happened?
There's a hell of an earthquake, and we've got windows and everything that's falling out. We've got a hell of a dust cloud.
Highway Patrol emergency.
Cypress section of the West Grand Freeway has come down.
The Cypress structure has collapsed.
We have a major injury accident, Cypress and West Grand. They're advising major injuries. We're attempting to get 1141.
We have a 50-foot section which is collapsed from westbound into eastbound.
Said the upper deck collapsed onto lower deck.
From westbound into eastbound, east of TI.
Emergency.
Yes, ma'am. My name is Steve Barnes. I'm at West Grand Avenue. Cypress section of the West Grand Freeway has come down. I saw at least three or four trucks come over the top.
I think the whole section of the overhead just collapsed. Overhead.
Our Cypress structure in Oakland has just fallen through.
We'll check the ambulance responses. 3-2 in Cypress.
We can go to 880 in Cypress.
Yeah, you heard me.
Truck is upside down. This
is awful.
We have a complete structural collapse. Entire freeway between the streets of between 17th Street as far as I can see going towards 32nd. So we're going to need some trucks down here as soon as you can get them.
Oakland 2, engine 5.
Engine 5.
We need a truck at 32nd and Cypress.
Just get them started on that top rung until we get some security up there.
Okay.
You got two bodies down there?
Yeah.
All right. We're going to slide them down.
We need a truck at 32nd and Cypress. The entire overhead of the freeway is down all the way to Highway 580. We need a truck company at 32nd and Cypress. Do you have ambulances coming to 32nd and Cypress? And also truck company if you've got one available.
We got one casualty right here. It's going to be in between decks with people trapped. So let's start to see if we can get a ladder in here.
I'll have to go around the block.
Oakland 2.
Yeah, they have people trapped on Cypress. They want you to respond to Cypress and work your way towards West Grand Avenue. They have people trapped all along.
You are to respond to 32nd and Cypress.
Yes, Fire Alarm. My truck company is 32nd.
has collapsed into the eastbound section, about a 50-foot section.
Okay, let me check.
Report we had, there was a lot of people hurt under where the collapse.
Okay, let me check.
Yes, we're getting the calls on that now.
All right, ma'am.
The gas collapsed, yes, and we're trying to get all the people off the bridge now.
So you're just going to turn the cars around and try to get them off?
Get them off the best way we can. Yes, ma'am.
Did you contact traffic? He wants the bridge closed down on the west side until we find out how long it's going to be closed.
Turn them around at the Sterling Street exit. Get them going the wrong way. Evacuate this portion of the bridge. That's the only way we're going to clear the deck. 2,000 to 3,000 people outside of their cars. West of the tunnel to east of the tunnel.
The eastbound needs to be shut down at the west end. Then get the motors turned around and going the wrong way and clear them off that way so that we get the entire bridge shut off and get the cars off the bridge.
Has sent as many helicopters as possible, but they'll have to go to the Cypress structure first. We have people trapped underneath.
Three pillars down in the center section. There should be two live people. You might be able to use your 24-foot ladder to get to them.
We need a pumper. We have a semi-trailer truck on fire under the collapsed portion of the freeway.
This is Engine 1. Check, get a battalion chief down here. We've got four injured now here. Watch. Get the laughter shock. We just got one.
On the freeway collapse, there is a multi-casualty unit at 17th and Cypress. Bring all your injuries to 17th and Cypress.
We'll need a couple ambushes if you've got them in your hip pocket at 30 seconds in the freeway collapse.
But we just got the ladder down now.
He's down the pocket. Real bad down here, Andy.
And Cypress incident, they're working on extrication of three children.
Oh, it's part of this collapse falling, but I don't have any company up that way, and we have fire and people trapped. Report people trapped at that end and just begin to work their way down to West Grand Avenue.
Yeah, they have people trapped on Cypress. I want you to respond to Cypress and work your way towards West Grand Avenue. They have people trapped all along.
We're going to work our way all the way down. You've got rescues going independently with people with contractor and equipment. We've got cops, we've got CHP, we've got civilians. So what we need to do is start probably working our way down, keep one lane of traffic clear, work our way into each incident and get an analysis. We've got about a half a mile of a collapsed structure. Every bit is going to have to be searched. You're going to have to pull out the stops and call for a general alarm.
Bumper 1 is on Cypress.
Helicopters here evacuating people, Colin.
Pumper 1, I need my Hurst tool, please.
Okay. Total chaos. It's terrible. It's terrible. There's a lot of people under this tent.
All right, whoever's commanding the incident, we've got four people pinned.
People trapped at Cypress and Campbell.
Humping and jumping and the cars are falling down. The dust is like dust is going all over. Rocks were flying. People
here on time and as much heavy rescue equipment as we can.
Truck 15, meet Engine 5 at 32nd and Cypress. They need a truck.
Yeah, we need the jaws of life.
Get another engine company.
Delta 14, Unit 2, Engine 2, Engine 1, Truck 3, Battalion 2.
We want it. The upper deck, 8 feet at least, the upper deck of the same bridge has collapsed. It collapsed onto the lower deck and then went into the water. Some cars were caught on
At 5:35 p.m., 31 minutes after the earthquake, a 1980 Mercury Zephyr, driven by a 23-year-old woman, entered the westbound upper deck of the Bay Bridge and drove eastbound in the wrong direction for approximately 2 miles. The vehicle was traveling at approximately 49 miles per hour when it became airborne and flew 35 and one-half feet across the gap and impacted the fallen portion of the upper roadway deck.
This car managed to get on the bridge. It tried to fly across this 50-foot gap and didn't make it.
After impact, the front wheels became caught and suspended the vehicle and its occupants high above the lower deck.
down the bridge. Coast Guard helicopter advises they have reports of injuries in that area and are available for medevac. They are over you now. Repeating, 30G at Atlanta Bridge, they have reports of injuries. The Coast Guard helicopter is over the bridge at this time and are available for medevac.
Report we had, there was a lot of people hurt under where the collapse.
81, are you closer to the collapsed area of the bridge? If so, the Coast Guard helicopter will be flying overhead and we're there for medevac to take injuries out if necessary.
Report, ways away, I'll be there shortly.
I'm with paramedics that have just returned from the scene of...
10-4 copy, two only entries. The bridge is on top, pulling cars out of the hole.
Both the driver and her brother were extricated and transported to Letterman Army Hospital by Coast Guard helicopter. The driver of the vehicle was pronounced dead on arrival. Her brother was hospitalized with major injuries. The results of the California Highway Patrol's investigation revealed that the driver did not appear to brake and took no other apparent evasive action before driving into the gap created by the collapse of the westbound deck. An examination of the driver's side restraint system indicated it was not in use at the time of impact. The passenger, however, was wearing a seatbelt and survived.
Oakland 2, this is Chief 2.
Stand by, Chief. Engine 5, I'll check for your ETA.
And I'll check on you if you've got one available.
Yeah, I think we're clear on the upper deck. All the damage is going to be in between decks.
Hawk 1, disregard the response to Vernon. You are to respond to 32nd and Cypress.
Check 1. Truck 1, sir.
Oakland.
To rescue on this building, there is no depth from the tip. Engine 12 in service on the air.
Upper channel engine 10.
5 in the ETA.
When we first found him, it was about a half an hour after the earthquake, and the structure was still falling. So we chocked it and used large jacks to keep it from falling down any further. And through perseverance and persistence, we got him out. He was caught underneath the steering wheel. When the structure fell, he was off to the right side. That's the only thing that helped him survive. His right leg was underneath the dash, and that's what was preventing him from being extracted. We cut the seat, pulled the stuffing out from under the seat, cut the springs out from the seat to help him drop down, and the fire guys were just incredible. They are the ones that I would say did the 98% of the job.
In one crushed car, a 7-year-old boy was trapped beneath the body of his dead mother. To save the boy, the mother had to be removed. Surgeon James Betts.
Decision was made at that time to actually remove as much of her as we could, knowing that we couldn't totally extricate her. The other surgeon and I